Hey everyone, we've got a lot going on behind the scenes here at the King of Random, and we want to keep you in the loop. So if you are interested in being the first to know about exclusive news and offers, go ahead and click the link in the description and sign up for our mailing list. A while ago, we used some kinetic sand and some molten gallium to cast a small version of Grant's face. Today, we wanted to scale that up, and we're going to be trying to make a life-size cast of my face in metal. This kinetic sand stuff is really cool, and it compresses down, holding a surprising amount of detail, which is why before we took this little 3D print of Grant's face, used it to make a mold, and then cast some gallium into that sand. That worked out really well, and today we want to try scaling that up. We've got quite a bit more kinetic sand, and we're going to see if we can do a full-size casting of my face. What we're going for here is pretty simple. We're going to take a bunch of kinetic sand, put it into a box, and then try smushing my face into the sand to make a mold, filling it with molten gallium, which should cool off into a solid metal face. So we've got kinetic sand here, 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 and here, and then we've got a bunch of gallium, and this stuff is super cool, by which I mean it's molten while it's quite cool. I can easily put my hand in it without any worry of burning because it's just not that hot. Our thermometer is actually currently registering the surface as below the freezing point of gallium, which means it should be solidifying, and it is a little bit. We've got sort of a skin on here. This gallium is currently just barely warm enough to stay liquid. It's cooling down fairly quickly, and we start getting solid parts, and this can easily remelt, including just by putting it down at the bottom of this, but it is cooling off quite a bit. When it's hot, it stays bright and silvery a lot quicker, but this is cool, so as I clear a space away, it just starts freezing, and you can see it stopped being quite so silvery very quickly. So the goal is going to be to take our kinetic sand, put that into a box, and try and smush my face into it well enough that we can cast it in gallium. But I do have a couple other things I want to try. I have a bunch of colored sand, and I actually just want to see what it looks like pouring the molten gallium into that colored sand. So I'm going to do a few experiments with that too. Sand is so much lighter weight that it's actually just floating on top. Gallium pours into sand fairly interestingly. The sand sort of floats on top of it. We've seen that it does not behave the same way with kinetic sand, especially if we smash it down. So let's take all of our kinetic sand, put it in this box, and see if I can make a mold of my face. I've got two methods that we're gonna try. First, I'm gonna see what happens if I actually just smush my face down into this sand. I'll hold my breath, keep my eyes closed, and press my face down in, see what sort of indentation I can get. Now, the sand has some good give to it, but so does my face, so do all faces. So I'm afraid that may or may not work out too well, but I do have a plan B. But let's try this. Take off my glasses, got a towel for when I pull my face out so I can just wipe it all off. Things I do for you guys.
It's like if I were turned into Voldemort and Voldemort had a beard. You can see all my facial hair. It picked up all the detail, but like my whole face is so smashed flat.
So smushing my face down into the sand gave an impression of an extremely smushed face. That's not quite what we're going for, entertaining as that is to look at. So we do have a plan B. Several years ago, helping out in a friend's makeup class, I had this made. This is actually a copy of my face. If my face had no hair on top, no eyebrows, no facial hair, nothing. But that's me right there. This is made of what I believe is called UltraCal. It's sort of a cross between plaster and cement. It's really, really hard, much harder than my face and much harder than the kinetic sand. And so if we press this down into the kinetic sand, we should just get a nice imprint without any deformation. We're gonna do that now. We're gonna get the sand back to being fluffy, and then we're gonna set this up so we can tip it down and just smush it down into the sand and hopefully get a nice, clean, unsmashed version of my face in the kinetic sand. We've got the face smushed in pretty good, and I'm just trying to smush down all of the rest of the sand so it's properly reinforced and will hold its shape. I think that's all right. I'm just gonna kinda grab me by my ears here and... We have my face smushed into the sand, and in theory, my current actual face should fit nicely down into that, and I'm gonna see if it does. That fits quite nicely. I guess I shouldn't really be surprised. It's my face after all, but like it goes down in and I can just feel it lightly touching all parts of my face and maybe getting pink sand on it. I don't know about that. But now we're gonna round up all of the gallium that we have and slowly, carefully pour it in there. That way we'll have a metal cast of my face. Random fact, kinetic sand is made out of 98% regular sand and 2% polydimethyl siloxane, an important component of silly putty. That is as full as we can get it. Okay guys, my face has now been poured in gallium and we need to let this cool down, and that actually takes quite a while. The gallium, when it's in a liquid state, likes to hold onto it for a while, and so it's gonna take some time for this to all freeze back into a solid block. Once it is, we can pull it out of the sand and see if we have a metal cast of my face. Okay, I think it's time for the main event. Let's try pulling this face out. Oh. Well, our sand's sticking to it, but I think we've got something face-like showing up. Well, I think that worked out pretty nicely. Now, it's a little bit hard to see the similarities when you're just looking at an all one color face that doesn't have the rest of the head or hair on it, but I think that did a really good job. And you can see pretty much just the same shape. Now I have my lovely metal face to go along with my lovely concrete face and my okay skin-made face. I wanna see if I can't polish this up just a little bit so we can have like a shiny metal look. Casting my face in kinetic sand, that actually worked really well. Of course, we had to use my stone-like face to really get the mold because I was getting a very smushed look when I just pressed my face down into the kinetic sand, although that was pretty fun too. But overall, I think we had a great result. I don't know what I'm going to do with a metal face of myself, but it's pretty neat. This kinetic sand works really well for casting gallium. Gallium melts at such a low temperature, like 85 degrees Fahrenheit, that it doesn't burn the kinetic sand the way like molten aluminum does. There may be some other things that will cast really well in kinetic sand too. We'd love to hear your ideas of what you'd like to see us try. It is still a granule sand, so we don't want to do things that are too liquid. I suspect most types of resin would just seep right down through the sand, but maybe if we compact it enough, that wouldn't happen. We also may sometime decide to show you how to make one of these things for yourself. We've already got a stone cast Nate. Maybe we'll make a stone cast Grant. Guys, thanks for watching, but that's not all. That box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video, and you should go check that out. The other box will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you aren't a subscriber yet, just hit this bomb to get in the club, and that way you never miss a video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.